गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ इज एवरीबॉडी डूइंग?
आई एम ग्रेट।
ग्रेट, वेरी गुड। द वेदर इज ऑल्सो नाइस नाउ टुडे, प्लेजेंट, नो सन।
यस मैम।
नो हीट, नो राइज इन टेम्परेचर, राइट? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yesterday on the class groups, I had shared one PDF. In that PDF.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Angel.
In that. Morning, ma'am.
Good morning. In that PDF, all the work that is done for the chapter.
Good morning, ma'am.
Power resources, everything is done in that, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So please, yes, ma'am. Save it somewhere. Don't ask. Like there are some students, those who keep on asking for the work. Not from C-section, but other sections. So I made it a point of posting it in all the class groups, plus the D group also, right? So please keep it safe, right?
Morning, ma'am.
Good morning, Tarini. Today we'll start with the new chapter of geography, that is types of agriculture and
Major crops.
Right. Ma'am, when we have to send our work?
Good morning, ma'am.
Yesterday we completed with the work. Monday you people can send. Good morning, Vidushi.
When we have to send?
Ma'am, you told that you will tell us today in evening when we have to send.
Good morning, ma'am.
I told you for Saturday, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. So today, after at 9 sharp, you start sending your work. Because that is the time when no messages are forwarded, right?
No, ma'am.
Right?
Today we have to send the math work at night. Yes, ma'am.
I didn't get you.
Ma'am, we have to send our math work at 9.
Not math work, the whole work.
No, ma'am, math.
It's a math work.
Yes, ma'am.
Math work at 9, you have to send today.
Ma'am, we can send at 8.
No, 8 o'clock, we just send people, they keep on messaging, no, actually. So let us do one thing, Sunday, tomorrow, in the morning, you send 9 o'clock.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Right? Ma'am, we can send tomorrow.
Tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Right?
Okay, ma'am. What we have to send?
Yes, Anj?
Ma'am, what we have to send tomorrow, 9 a.m.?
Chapter 5 of Geography.
Okay, ma'am.
Fine. I think almost everybody is in. So I will not say anything. You will tell me, what do you know about agriculture? What do you think is agriculture? What are these types of agriculture?
Ma'am, agriculture is a process of growing a large amount of crop in a large area.
Okay. What if a person has a
small... Ma'am, rearing animals is also come under the agriculture.
Yes. See, agriculture is an activity that is undertaken for growing crops, and along with growing crops, cattle rearing also takes place, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now. If I ask you, in which activity this agriculture comes, like if I you have to categorize into primary, secondary, tertiary, so where will you put this agriculture?
Primary.
Yes, Ayush?
Ma'am, because everything starts from agriculture only.
Yes, everything starts from agriculture only. So we call it as a primary activity that is undertaken by the people, right? Now, why this is a primary activity? If you see in our country, like any other country, like India, any other country, if you take example of, you will find that most of the people, they, most of the industries which are there, out of those maximum number of industries that they have, there are some industries which are based on the raw material which is provided by the agriculture. Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Yes. So, see, when we talk of India, we all know that India is an agrarian economy. Agrarian means a country where most of the people are into cultivation. Right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Right? So India being an agrarian economy, it is very important for us to know that what kind of agricultural practices we follow in our country, what are the major crops that we grow in our country, and why only these particular crops only are grown, what are the reasons behind growing a specific crop only, right? Then we will also be reading about the factors which are responsible for the agricultural practices. Like, you know, if you talk about the factors that are responsible for various activities, like if I tell you, if I ask you, what are the factors affecting climate of a country? What are the factors affecting the weather of a place? What are the factors that affect the population of a region or a population of a country? So there are different factors for the same, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. Likewise, even for agriculture also, there are various factors that affect the agricultural practices in any region or a place, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then coming to the season, the cropping pattern that we follow in our country. See, when we talk of the cropping pattern in India, especially in the cultivation part, we follow, there are basically three seasons that we have, right? You must have done this in sciences also. Rabi season, Kharif season, and then in between Rabi and Kharif, we have a season Zayat, which is called as Zayat season.
Very good,
right? So, Zayat season, though the duration of this season is quite short, but still it is important because all the seasonal vegetables are grown during this particular season, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. If I ask you about the types of agriculture, so without looking into the book, can you tell me how many types of agriculture do we practice in our country? Different practices which we have.
Ma'am, fishing and
farming.
I
am talking about agriculture. Fishing comes in the primary activity. Mining comes in the primary activity. But I am talking about agriculture.
Rearing and grazing of animals.
Okay, rearing of animals. But then if I talk about the types.
Terrace farming.
Orchard, okay, very good. Orchard farming, very good. Ma'am. Somebody said terrace farming.
Terrace farming.
Okay, terrace farming. What else do we have?
Ma'am, step farming,
terrace farming. बात एक ही है.
Ma'am, contour plowing.
Contour plowing होती है, ठीक है, ठीक है. और क्या होता है? Have you ever heard of subsistence farming?
Yes, ma'am. The farmer grows crop for his farm.
Yes. And have you heard of commercial farming?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Commercial crops are grown.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Have you heard of intensive farming?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay. Have you heard of extensive farming?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Have you heard of mixed farming?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yes, mixed farming is basically when you grow multiple crops all together in a single field, right? Then have you heard of plantation?
Ma'am.
Have you heard of plantation farming or plantation cultivation?
In transplantation we have learned.
No, plantation, plantation only.
No,
no ma'am.
Okay, no, how many of you are fond of coffee and tea? Raise your hands.
Ma'am, me.
On the participants window, I'll see. Just raise your hands. Yes. Oh my God. A good number of students are fond of coffee and tea both. Very good. See, this tea and coffee, rubber, they come under the plantation cultivation. Right?
Right. Okay, ma'am.
Plantation cultivation, beta. PLANTATION. Plantation cultivation. Right?
Okay, ma'am.
So these are the huge varieties of, you know, agriculture that we are going to learn in this chapter. I think in your book, very few are given, but I will be telling you about every kind of cultivation so that in future, whenever anybody asks you, you are in a position to answer these questions, because people assume that from a particular class, when you are coming to the, you know, next level, you are aware of everything, right? So we should go in little deep details of the chapters, right?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
So how would you like to start, reading, or shall I carry on with the explanation part?
An explanation.
Explanation. No, right. Okay, have you heard of this primitive subsistence farming?
No, ma'am.
What is meant by primitive? What is meant by primitive?
Ma'am, to permit some.
Ma'am, peoples of tribes. Ma'am, they move from one place to another.
Primitive means something that is, you know, prevalent since ages or since olden times or ancient times, right? So primitive, when we say primitive, we go back in the past. We go to the early humans time, right? That is primitive, okay? So primitive subsistence farming is basically a practice of cultivation where the cultivation takes place with the traditional tools जानते हैं क्या होता है आपका हल ये सिकल हो
yes, ma'am, हो
ma'am, हो
हाँ हो सिकल और बस ये आपके major tools होते हैं जो कि traditional tools होते हैं and they are used for the cultivation under the primitive subsistence farming ठीक है और subsistence का मतलब होता है केवल जरूरत भर के लिए इस्तेमाल उगाना ठीक है या something that is grown only for the fulfilling of the needs of the family So primitive subsistence farming is something that that has all the you know that has all the traditional tools for the cultivation plus in this type of farming the family members are involved in the cultivation no high yielding variety seeds are used no modern methods are used no fertilizers no chemicals are used only everything organic is used the cow dung is used as manure right the ash of the wood or the ash of the coal is used to ensure no insects in the crops right
okay ma'am
fine now see this primitive subsistence farming is basically practiced in those areas where the people do not have facilities, where the land areas are quite small, and where the purpose is only to feed the family members, not to gain any kind of profit, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Right?
Now, when we talk of this primitive subsistence farming, this is mostly practiced in those places where the people are residing in the remote areas where they have small pieces of land under their, you know, governance or under their control. And these people, they are not concerned about the money making. They are merely concerned about the fulfilling the needs of the family members, right? Then coming to the this intensive subsistence farming. Intensive subsistence farming is a farming that is practiced that is practiced by the people in, you know, largely populated regions. Like if we take example of UP, we can say in UP, intensive subsistence farming takes place. Why it takes place? Because in UP, the percentage of people living in the country, in the state or various regions is comparatively more. Agar hum baat karte hain population concentration ki, to UP is the state that has largest number of people in it, right?
Yes,
so what is the basic difference between intensive and subsistence primitive? The basic difference is that in intensive subsistence farming, we use modern methods, we use fertilizers, we use chemicals also, and we grow multiple crops so that, you know, we don't have to buy crops from outside. And sometimes when the crop yield is more, after utilizing them, we are left with sufficient amount that can be sold in the market. So in intensive subsistence farming, modern methods are used, chemicals and fertilizers are used so that they can have, you know, more production of a particular crop. And the land is divided into several fragments where different types of crops are grown in a single season on a single piece of land. So this is called as intensive subsistence farming. And this intensive subsistence farming is practiced in basically those areas or those regions where population concentration is quite high, right? Can you tell me the states where this intensive cultivation takes place, keeping in mind the population concentration?
In Bengal.
Maharashtra. Okay. Uttar Pradesh. Then? One more state.
And Madhya Pradesh.
I'm Punjab.
No. Punjab mein intensive cultivation hota hai.
Rajasthan. Ma'am, Haryana.
नहीं
मैम ओडिशा
मैम बिहार
ओडिशा में भी नहीं बिहार वेरी गुड तारिणी बिहार सी बिहार इज द स्टेट दैट हैज
झारखंड
नहीं झारखंड में भी नहीं बेटा झारखंड में तो आपके माइंस वगैरह है ना मिनरल्स वगैरह बहुत ज्यादा है वहां पे तो वहां पे आपका आयरन एंड स्टील के जो है आपको इंडस्ट्री ज्यादा मिलेंगे ठीक है यू विल फाइंड पीपल मोर इन टू दी माइनिंग पार्ट और आपका जो भी मिनरल बेस्ड इंडस्ट्रीज है दे आर मोर ओवर द झारखंड रीजन राइट झारखंड हुआ वेस्ट बंगाल का आपका वेस्टर्न पार्ट हुआ तो ये एरियाज वो हैं जहाँ पे बहुत ज्यादा मिनरल कंसंट्रेशन है तो यहाँ पे आपको आयरन एंड स्टील इंडस्ट्रीज मिलेंगी आपको जो है मिनरल बेस्ड इंडस्ट्रीज ज्यादा मिलेंगी यहाँ पे ठीक है बिहार आई वॉज टेलिंग यू अबाउट बिहार इनिशियली डेंसिटी ऑफ पॉपुलेशन यू नो वॉट इज डेंसिटी ऑफ पॉपुलेशन
यस
आई यूज टेल वॉट इज डेंसिटी ऑफ पॉपुलेशन
And when in the area there people live in very large amount.
हाँ तो उसकी एक 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 particular definition है उसकी हम कैसे define करते हैं उसको anybody in the class?
हम number of people in per square kilometer.
Yes, the number of people living in per square kilometer area is defined as a density of population. इसको हिंदी में हम बोलते हैं जनसंख्या का घनत्व. ठीक है अगर कभी हिंदी में आप इस टर्म्स को पढ़ते हो तो आपको पता होना चाहिए व्हाट एग्जैक्टली दीज टर्म्स मीन इन इंग्लिश राइट तो डेंसिटी ऑफ पॉपुलेशन क्योंकि वेस्ट बंगाल की पहले ज्यादा थी बट 2011 के सेंसस जब हुआ उसमें पता चला कि बिहार हैज मोर ऑफ पीपल लिविंग पर स्क्वायर किलोमीटर राइट तो वो वेस्ट बंगाल से इट हैज शिफ्टेड टू बिहार नाउ तो दिस इज समथिंग ऑफ जनरल नॉलेज यू शुड बी अवेयर ऑफ राइट
Okay, ma'am.
Fine. Okay. Okay, now, ma'am. Intensive and primitive. Okay, intensive and primitive. Clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Fine. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now there is another type of cultivation that is carried yes, by ma'am. The nomads. You know who are nomads?
Yes, ma'am. The people.
Yes, ma'am.
Who come on
yes, ma'am. The people who move from
Yes.
Ma'am,
yes.
who do not have permanent
shelter. To travel from one place to another place in search of food and with their cattle, group yes. of cattle.
Nomads are the people, those who don't live in a settled, at a settled place. They keep on moving from one place to another, just like the early humans. They keep moving in search of food, right? So these nomads, they also practice a kind of cultivation, which is called as shifting cultivation, right? Which is called as? Shifting agriculture means the same. Now, what does this shifting mean? That they keep on, you know, when they grow something, they keep on shifting them, or what do you understand by this shifting wala thing?
When they burn the forest to make it.
Yes, yes.
Manure.
Forest and use that. Ma'am, the area for cultivation.
Yes, very good.
Ma'am, the first land is used for cultivation, then they move to another place and then grow the crop there. Ma'am, and then again, they burn the crops which was left in that field, and after some time, they move to there and again grow the crop.
Ha, very good. See, shifting cultivation is a kind of cultivation which is practiced by the people, those who don't live a settled life, right? So we can say nomads also. Now, these people, how do they carry this shifting cultivation? They keep on shifting from one patch of land to another patch of land after every 4 to 5 years. We all know that the land retains its fertility only for a duration of time. And when we are cultivating that land, it loses its fertility over a period of time. So when a patch of land is cleared, especially in the forest areas where the tribal groups are prominent, so in these places, what do? A patch of land they clear the forest, and whatever dry leaves are there or the stems are there or the branches are there, they burn those branches and leaves. And then in the ashes of those burnt leaves and branches, what do? They sow the seeds, right? And then continuously they till that land or they cultivate that land area, say for approximately 3 to 4 years or 4 to 5 years, till the land is giving them crops. And after that, they shift to another patch of land nearby area. And this is a cycle, you know, they keep on moving from one area to another area, and then over a period of time, they come back to the same patch of land, right? In history, class 8, you are in class 8, no? In history, you yes, must ma'am. Have read about the tribal revolt. Have you read of tribal revolt in the chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
In that
yes,
chapter, ma'am. You must yes, have ma'am. Read that the British...
Ma'am,
Jhum agriculture.
Exactly, exactly. And Jhum in northeast.
Northeast region, they are quite prominent. But then even in Madhya Pradesh also, the Chhattisgarh region that we have, plus this Jharkhand area, some parts of Jharkhand also, some parts of Gujarat also, some parts of Rajasthan also, some parts of Jammu and Kashmir. Everywhere throughout the country, where the tribal groups are prominent, where the forest areas are, you know, prominent, in those places or those areas or those regions, we have this shifting cultivation taking place. Now, shifting cultivation was considered as a practice which was not good for the land, which used to degrade the quality of the land by the British, by the Europeans, right? So this shifting cultivation was confined only to some regions, some areas where the tribal groups are present, right? Even in the present time also, people are into shifting cultivation. But then if you compare it with the past, you will find that not many of them are there in the subsistence or the shifting cultivation, right? Right? Shifting cultivation clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Then, yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, you know why shifting cultivation is considered as a bad practice of cultivation or of agriculture? Because it, you know, encourages deforestation. Like, because these people, they live in forest, so they go for the cutting down of the trees or the felling of the trees take place, and then only the cultivation takes place. So this way, it has been banned by the government as well, so that no more forest cover is depleted. Because we need, keeping in mind the global warming, we need to ensure a good forest cover in the country, right? Right, class?
Yes, ma'am.
Then coming to the nomadic herding. Nomadic herding, someone said that when people move along with their cattle, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Now see, in this nomadic herding, the main purpose of the nomads is to grow the life, is to have the livestock, right? To rear the cattle that can give them, you know, milk, that can give them flesh for their food, right? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
This nomadic herding is again quite popular in those areas, those places of the world, of the country where the tribal groups are prominent. where the tribal groups are living, right? फिर वो चाहे आपका केरला हो, चाहे साउथ हो, आपका चाहे वो आपका नॉर्थ हो, जम्मू कश्मीर हो, चाहे वो राजस्थान हो, चाहे वो आपका सेंट्रल पार्ट ऑफ द कंट्री हो, मध्य प्रदेश हो, या फिर आपके नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न स्टेट्स हो, राइट? I hope the subsistence farming is clear and understood to everyone.
Yes, ma'am.
Now coming to the commercial farming. See, when we say commercial farming, we are actually concerned about the profit that we can make by practicing agriculture, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Right?
Yes,
now, ma'am. When we talk of the commercial agriculture, this extensive farming that I told you, in the beginning, this extensive farming takes place in the commercial agriculture. Now, what is this extensive farming?
I'm growing crop in a very large amount.
Yes. On large areas, large pieces of land. Like if you see, if we compare Indian farms and USA farms, we will find that in India, the land holdings that the farmers have, they are comparatively quite small in size. Whereas in America, a single farmer has a huge land under his control for the cultivation. Right? In India, just 1 hectare is there. And in America, I'm just giving a rough estimate, more than 5 or 6 hectares land is there, which is cultivated by the US farmer. And in India, just not more than 1 hectare land is there with a farmer. So, इस तरीके का जो variation है बेटा, ये variation बहुत ज़्यादा responsible होता है कि profit making जो हम करते हैं from the agriculture, वो profit making हमारी नहीं हो पाती है. Reason being, we tend to grow multiple crops, and in the tendency of growing multiple crops, we forget that the profit will also be very less. If you go for the multiple cropping, in that case, if you have a small piece of land in multiple cropping, what happens? The per hectare production, the space, I'll just show it to you. See, suppose this is a field, right? And it has been divided into parts, right? Now, when we compare it, like these fragments which I have made, in this these fragments, people, what do? They grow different crops. Now, this particular portion that we have, the per hectare production of this area will be more. Why? Because in small part, a small portion of crop is grown, where when this comes out to be the finished product, when you compare it, you will find that the per hectare production is more. Whereas the total production of this whole field, if you compare, that will be very less. Right? This is the case.
Yes.
This is the case in the intensive cultivation. In commercial farming, what do people do? They do not fragment the land like this. They simply divide it into two parts, right? They divide the land into two parts and they grow only those crops which are highly demanded. And the purpose of going for commercial farming is only that they want maximum profit out of minimum input. ठीक है? तो ये motive क्या है commercial farming में? Commercial farming is exclusively done for making profit, for making money. Whatever they grow, they do not consume it within the family. They grow it for the market. They want to sell it to the market, right? So that they can gain maximum profit. And high yielding variety seeds are used. All the modern methods are used for the cultivation in the commercial farming. Right? This much is clear and understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Up till here, anything that you have not understood, class?
No, ma'am. Not
all understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Beta, we have got just 9 minutes with us. So can we go for the reading of the initial part that we have read, I have explained to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay. Yes, yeah. Ridhima, yes, reading ma'am. The first paragraph. Ridhima, first paragraph.
Yeah, ma'am. Chapter 6, Types of Agriculture and Major Crops. The term agriculture means the cultivation of soil for the growing of crops. It also includes raising livestock, forestry, and fishing. Agriculture has evolved down the ages from the primitive subsistence type to the modern commercial and mechanized type.
Done? Okay, second. Can we have Tarani reading? Second paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. Factors influencing agriculture. These are some of the factors that influence agriculture in a region are climate. Elements of climate such as temperature and rainfall play an important role in determining agricultural activities all over the world. For example, in the warm tropical regions, agriculture can be practiced throughout the year, while in the higher latitudes, the winter temperature is too low for the growth of crops. Some crops like rice and jute require more moisture and thus grow in areas of high rainfall, while wheat and millets grow in the drier areas.
Okay. This climate part is clear and understood to everyone?
Yes,
yes,
ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Climate plays a very important role. If we see why we call our country as an agrarian country, because India comes in the monsoon type of climate country, right? Where, like, if we talk about Asia, southeast and southwest of Asian continent that we have, people are more into agriculture because the climate type is such that it supports the agriculture also, right? During monsoons, we grow several crops, and like the Rabi season that we have, the Kharif season that we have, it is all because of the retreating monsoons and the onset of the monsoons. The rice crop is grown on the onset of monsoons, and the wheat crop is grown during the winter season, November, December, right? Right? So climate plays very important role. Plus temperature also, the rainfall also. Those places which are drier, not much of crops are grown over there. The places which have moderate rainfall, there, you know, people grow those crops which do not require extra water. And in the tropical areas, especially the places which are closer to equator, there throughout the year cultivation takes place because sunlight is ample and water rainfall is also sufficient, right? And plus those places, if we talk about the relief part, like this was climate, if we talk about the relief part and if we talk about the soil type, the soils which are fertile, there, you know, every kind of crop is grown. Like we have done in chapter 2, I believe that alluvial soil is considered to be the most fertile soil. Then we have the black soil, yes, which supports the cotton crops. Then we have read about the laterite soil. We have read about the red soil or the yellow soils, right? Right? So there are different types of soils found in different geographic divisions of the country. And these soils, they, you know, what do? These soils, they support different types of crops, right? So that is why there are so many varieties of, you know, food crops that are grown in our country. Food crops as well as non-food crops, the beverage crops that we have, plus, you know, beverage crops, you know, which all are beverage crops?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can Niruz, can you tell me which crops are called as beverage crops? Okay, fine. Payal, can we have you ask telling? Payal?
Okay,
yes, beta, tell Bhavya.
Ma'am, it's tea, barley, rice, etc.
Beverage crop, beverage. Beverage matlab drinks, jo hote hai, liquid.
Tea and coffee.
Only tea and coffee are considered as the beverage crop. Okay, or sugar cane, jo hai, it comes under the this thing, cash crop. Commercial.
And ma'am, sugar cash crop.
What one?
Ma'am, sugar beet.
Sugar beet. Nahin. Sugar beet exactly kya hota hai? Mujhe nahin pata. Batao kya hota hai? Sugar beet कौन सा crop होता है तारिनी?
Ma'am, chukundar.
That is beetroot.
Yes, ma'am.
There was one more thing called.
Yeah, beetroot. Ma'am, it was. Listen, beetroot. बीटरूट इज नॉट अ बेवरेज क्रॉप बेटा, इट इज, इट कम्स अंडर द फूड क्रॉप ओनली. ठीक है, ठीक है.
Ma'am, it is used for commercial for sugar purposes.
Beetroot?
No, ma'am, sugar beet.
Sugar beet is basically sugar, sugar cane. Sugar cane. Sugar cane के लिए use होता है ये. But ये जो है आपका sugar cane does not come in the beverage crop, क्योंकि sugar cane से हम beverages नहीं बनाते हैं, drinks नहीं बनाते हैं. हम sugar cane से we make solid sugar, we make jaggery, गुड़, चीनी, ये सब तो बनता है उससे, है ना? तो उसको हम बेवरेज क्रॉप नहीं बोलेंगे, रेदर इट इज कॉल्ड एज द कमर्शियल क्रॉप और अ कैश क्रॉप. वी डिफाइन इट एज अ कैश क्रॉप, क्योंकि उस जो शुगर केन का जो क्रॉप है ये मार्केट में इसकी डिमांड बहुत ज्यादा है. आप देखो चीनी, शुगर इज यूज्ड इन एवरीथिंग, और आज की डेट में पीपल आर बिकमिंग सो अवेयर दैट दे हैव स्विच्ड फ्रॉम शुगर टू जैगरी. चाहे जैगरी हो चाहे शुगर हो, दोनों को शुगर केन से ऑब्टेन किया जाता है, इसीलिए शुगर केन का डिमांड जो है मार्केट में बहुत ज्यादा है. ठीक है, राइट क्लास?
ओके मैम.
हाँ, तो ये जो क्लाइमेट, सॉइल और रिलीफ है, अब रिलीफ की अगर हम बात करते हैं, आप देखो जो हमारी अर्ली सिविलाइजेशंस डेवलप हुई थी बिकॉज ऑफ द एग्रीकल्चर, वो सब कहाँ पे डेवलप हुई थी? नियर द रिवर वैलीज, राइट? तो जो रिलीफ होता है, जो रिवर वैलीज, जो एरियाज, जो भी जिन एरियाज में, जिन प्लेसेस में, जिन, अगर हम इंडिया की बात करते हैं, जिन फिजियोग्राफिक डिविजन में आपका जो ड्रेनेज बेसिन वगैरह बने हुए हैं, जैसे गंगा ब्रह्मपुत्र बेसिन है पूरा अपना, आपका जो नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स है इट इज कम्प्लीटली कवर्ड विद एलुवियल सॉइल. ठीक है, अब ये जो एलुवियल सॉइल है ये बिकॉज इट इज वेरी फर्टाइल, तो आप देखो जितने भी स्टेट्स के थ्रू ये गंगा ब्रह्मपुत्र बेसिन पास होता है वहां पे एक्सक्लूसिवली आपका एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिसेस ही सबसे ज्यादा है, और सबसे ज्यादा एग्रो बेस्ड इंडस्ट्रीज भी इन्हीं एरियाज में जो है वो डेवलप हुई है, राइट? राइट रिलीफ इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर इन द सेंस कि रिलीफ, जिस जगह का रिलीफ जैसा होगा वहां पे उस तरीके की चीजों को जो है इनिशिएट किया जाएगा. जैसे अगर आप देखो डेक्कन प्लेट्यू जो है वहां पे ब्लैक सॉइल मिलता है, सम पार्ट्स ऑफ डेक्कन प्लेट्यू में आपको ब्लैक सॉइल का प्रोमिनेंस है. कुछ डेक्कन प्लेट्यू का जो पार्ट है वो आपका रॉकी सर्फेसेस है, वहां पे मिनरल्स का कंसंट्रेशन बहुत ज्यादा है, तो जितनी भी मिनरल इंडस्ट्रीज है वो वहीं पे कन्फाइंड है. ठीक है, और जो आपके एलुवियल सॉइल वाला जो एरिया है वहां पे जो है आपका क्योंकि वहां पे वो फर्टाइल सॉइल है तो वहां पे एग्रीकल्चरल प्रैक्टिसेस सबसे ज्यादा है, वहां पे फूड क्रॉप्स जो है वो ग्रो करी जाती है. ठीक है, फिर आपकी लेटराइट सॉइल हो गई, इनमें इन ये सॉइल्स भी जो है कुछ पर्टिकुलर क्रॉप्स के लिए मतलब कंसिडर करी जाती है एज फर्टाइल, बट हर तरीके की क्रॉप के नॉट बी ग्रोन ओवर देयर. वीट राइस आप यहाँ पे ग्रो नहीं कर सकते हो, वीट राइस अगर आपको ग्रो करना है तो आपको उसके लिए एडिशनल एफर्ट्स करने पड़ेंगे, आपको एडिशनल जो है इनपुट्स देने पड़ेंगे, तो उसके लिए तो फिर वो बहुत एक्सपेंसिव हो जाएगा किसी के लिए भी. तो जो चीजें इजीली वहां पे ग्रो हो जाती हैं उनमें, उन्हीं को ग्रो किया जाता है. ठीक है, जैसे लेटराइट सॉइल जो है वो कैश्यू नट्स के लिए बहुत बेनिफिशियल मानी जाती है, काजू जिसको हम बोलते हैं. तो जो भी सॉइल टाइप है उसमें जो भी क्रॉप टाइप इजीली ग्रो कर जाएगा उसी को हम ग्रो करते हैं, सो दैट वी डोंट हैव टू स्पेंड एक्स्ट्रा मनी ऑन इट. पाइल इट इज ओके, इट इज फाइन, नो इश्यूज बेटा. I hope this, chalo, can we have Riddhima reading quickly about the soil types?
Okay, ma'am. Soil. Soils vary in their chemical compositions and hence different types of soils are suitable for different crops. For example, rice grows best in clay, alluvial soil with black lava soil is suitable for cotton.
Relief.
Relief. The low-lying lands like plants, plains, river valleys, and deltas are more suitable for cultivation of crops than hilly areas. This explains why in India, the northern plains provide the best agriculture land as compared to the Himalayas for the Deccan Plateau.
Okay, fine.
Socioeconomic.
But meeting is going to end any minute. So now, rest of the things in the next class that we have. Fine.